I had been hearing that word syndication for probably 2 or 3 years on Bigger Pockets at the time that I started my company, the Marota Group. And it was always a little bit mysterious to me. I was like, what is this thing? But the little bit that I heard about it, I realized that doesn't sound super complicated. And I think one of the reasons why it was not complicated nor intimidating to me was because of my experience on Wall Street. And then the other position I had as a COO was as the COO of one of the largest real estate brokerages in the state of Washington. And when I worked for the company, the regulatory solutions company, I dealt all day long with attorneys and regulations and the world's largest financial institutions. So if you know anything about syndications, they're dealing with attorneys, finances with the world's largest banking institutions, sometimes local banks, and a lot of regulations, right? As well as investor relations and all this other stuff that comes along with it. But I felt like at least I knew a little bit about all of those things, and that wasn't intimidating to me. So I just started diving in and finding information that would help me meet my goals. I think the first place I went was Bigger Pockets. I started reading as much as I could about apartment investing at that time. And I know Michael Blanc was a great resource for me early on. And from there, I just started. It was like a rabbit hole. I just kept on going down whatever path that I could find. And from the time that I decided to do syndication, which was, I think, March of 2017, my goal was to have my first apartment under contract and closed by, well, under contract by September. So I was going to give myself 6 months to learn everything that I needed to learn. Well, by May, I had my first one under contract. And I closed on that in July. So it was like 2 months after I had made the decision. And I think part of that was because I was very, very intentional, and I started talking to everybody that I knew about what it was that I wanted to achieve and wanted to see how those relationships could help move me forward. And mind you, when we did single family investing, we were not using other people's money. I wasn't going to networking meetings. I wasn't known as an investor. We were just my husband and I doing stuff on our own. And so I had to really make a name for myself and get, I guess, increase my believability score with others to achieve what I wanted to achieve. So where did I find out what I needed to know? It was a combination of Bigger Pockets, lots of podcasts. I probably read a couple of books, not necessarily on syndication, but more of things like tax strategies and some of the higher level stuff that's related with real estate investing. And just talking to a lot of brokers and property managers and anybody I could.
You talked about increasing your believability. Can you elaborate on that a little bit and help the listeners, you know, to be able to do the same thing?
Yeah. Being believable is so important. So I'm going to give you an example. Hi, Whitney. My name is Tamar. I like apartments and I want to buy one someday. Okay. Right. Like you're like, oh, right. Awesome. That's going to be a rad conversation with this person. She seems pumped. Or I can walk and be like, Whitney, I'm so happy to meet you. I've been hearing about you. I love what you're doing. Listen, these are some of my goals and objectives. I'm so excited to reach them. I want to tell you about what I've been learning and see if you can share anything with me. What, is that cool with you? Can we have a conversation? Right?
That's great. Yeah.
What are you leaning towards?
That's a great example. Thank you so much. Yeah.
So I think I tend to be a person that doesn't lack exuberance. So, and so that comes with it. And sometimes you have to practice those things. You have to practice having those types of conversations with people. But if I just started getting sought out by some, like Marcus and Millichap started reaching out to me recently, and I'm like, oh my gosh, they're reaching out to me. Now they want my business instead of me going after their business, or them to help me achieve my goals. And it's because I've been putting myself out there and I say, this is what I want and this is how I'm going to get it. And part of that, you know, in a syndication business is creating a thought leadership platform like you're doing and like I've done with my podcast and speaking engagements and maybe blog articles or whatever, and or putting together a nice resume for the bankers that you want to work with or your investors, because they all want to know if you can do what you say you're going to do. And nobody's going to believe you unless you have confidence in yourself, first of all. And then they need to be able to see that you have that confidence in yourself. And I'm not talking about like a cocky sort of confidence. It's just like that little example I gave you. You're not going to believe the person that sounds like a mouse. And, you know, this is my goal. Super excited about it. But, and it's funny because I recently had a dinner with one of my broker friends, commercial broker, and we've known each other for about a year and a half now, and he helped me with my first apartment acquisition. He goes, Tamar, I never would have known that you didn't know what you were talking about that first day that we met. And he was one of the very first people that I talked to after I decided that I was going to start this business. So this, you know, tell a story and tell it well.
Isn't that funny? You can go back with him now and laugh about that, but that's great. It's great advice. Got to have confidence in yourself for sure.